to Joash the king's son, and say, Thus saith the king, Put this in the prison, and feed him with bread of affliction and with water of affliction, until I come in peace. And Micaiah said, If thou return at all in peace, the Lord hath not spoken by me. And he said, Hearken, O people, every one of you. So the king of Israel and Jehoshaphat the king of Judah went up to Ramothgilead. And the king of Israel said unto Jehoshaphat, I will disguise myself, and enter into the battle, but put thou on thy robes. And the king of Israel disguised himself, and went into the battle. But the king of Syria commanded his 32 captains that had rule over his chariots, saying, Fight neither with small nor great, save only with the king of Israel. And it came to pass, when the captains of the chariots saw Jehoshaphat, that they said, Surely it the king of Israel. And they turned aside to fight against him, and Jehoshaphat cried out. And it came to pass, when the captains of the chariots perceived that it not the king of Israel, that they turned back from pursuing him. And a man drew a bow at a venture, and smote the king of Israel between the joints of the harness, wherefore he said unto the driver of his chariot, Turn thine hand, and carry me out of the host, for I am wounded. And the battle increased that day, and the king was stayed up in his chariot against the Syrians, and died at even, and the blood ran out of the wound into the midst of the chariot. And there went a proclamation throughout the host about the going down of the sun, saying, Every man to his city, and every man to his own country. So the king died, and was brought to Samaria, and they buried the king in Samaria, and washed the chariot in the pool of Samaria, and the dogs licked up his blood, and they washed his armour, according unto the word of the Lord which he spake. Now the rest of the acts of Ahab, and all that he did, and the ivory house which he made, and all the cities that he built, they not written in the book of the chronicles of the kings of Israel? So Ahab slept with his fathers, and Ahaziah his son reigned in his stead. And Jehoshaphat the son of Asa began to reign over Judah in the fourth year of Ahab king of Israel. Jehoshaphat 35 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 25 years in Jerusalem. And his mother's name Azubah the daughter of Shilhi. And he walked in all the ways of Asa his father, he turned not aside from it, doing right in the eyes of the Lord. Nevertheless the high places were not taken away, the people offered and burned incense yet in the high places. And Jehoshaphat made peace with the king of Israel. Now the rest of the acts of Jehoshaphat, and his might that he showed, and how he warred, they not written in the book of the chronicles of the kings of Judah. And the remnant of the sodomites, which remained in the days of his father Asa, he took out of the land, then no king in Edom, a deputy king. Jehoshaphat made ships of Tharshish to go to Ophir for gold, but they went not, for the ships were broken at Eziongeber. Then said Ahaziah the son of Ahab unto Jehoshaphat, Let my servants go with thy servants in the ships. But Jehoshaphat would not. And Jehoshaphat slept with his fathers, and was buried with his fathers in the city of David his father, and Jehoram his son reigned in his stead. Ahaziah the son of Ahab began to reign over Israel in Samaria the 17th year of Jehoshaphat king of Judah, and reigned 2 years over Israel. And he did evil in the sight of the Lord, and walked in the way of his father, and in the way of his mother, and in the way of Jeroboam the son of Nebat, who made Israel to sin, for he served Baal, and worshipped him, and provoked to anger the Lord God of Israel, according to all that his father had done. This content was provided by AngeloTricarico.com. Subscribe to the channel for more stories.